kept her eyes on the prize. She held on, she held on. Oh, well, the last thing you'll do wrong is stay in the wilderness a day too long. Just keep your eyes on the prize. Hold on. I've been in and out of court and dealing with the election because Super Tuesday is Tuesday, and a friend of mine tried to commit suicide this week. And I just said, Rhonda, how do you expect me to come to D.C. at a time like this? But this sister has been such a treasure to Alabama and to the work I've done. So I couldn't say no, and I'm so glad I came. Because I got to see this giant again, to hear her. Y'all really heard for the giant. Just writing about her for the our 85th commemorative book for the Bloody Sunday commemoration that we'll be coming to in a week. And I call it Living Giant Still on the Battlefield.
Yeah.
And you see, she's what? She's
still on the battlefield.
Amen.
Now, I've been arrested. I've been arrested in court, out of court. People have threatened to kill me, but nothing I have been through compares to the danger that they faced in the 60s.
Nope.
Amen.
Nope.
Nothing
nope.
I've done.
Nothing.
Sister Laura Hall from Alabama, all right.
Yeah.
You know, I was arrested just last year at a Vote or Die campaign when a white man came to the polls. We had this campaign, Vote or Die, trying to stop Roy Moore from another pedophile from coming. This white man comes to the polls and threatens to kill me, you know? But I would have actually been killed 50 years ago. So thank you, my sister. Thank you so much. I want to talk to you, and what I'm going to say might bother some of you. But those who know me know I have to speak from my heart. You know that song. And of course, I've been attacked and criticized for doing that. And that's a price I pay. But you see, I know that voter suppression is not the major issue that we face as a people. Voter suppression is just the latest tactic, and there are tools of the arsenal of white supremacists to keep us at the bottom.
Say that.
And as my beloved Dr. Asa Hilliard said when he was alive, we're not no longer at the bottom of the barrel, we are under the barrel. And on my way to this workshop, I saw a workshop next door called The Criminalization of Poverty. See, all of us in this room have been blessed not because of our own talents, not because of our own excellence, but because there are people like you, my beloved sister,
Amen.
And people like Marie Foster, and so many people we don't even know by name, that took the brunt of the sacrifice, that really sacrificed their existence, so that we can sit here and read what?
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
And if we fail to remember them, what does the Bible say? The people are suffering from the lack of knowledge, and their children will suffer unless we gain what? That knowledge. There's no reason why we cannot gain that knowledge. Going back to